Welcome everyone to the Northwest Short Track Series Street Stock Race. It is today at Southern National. It is a pre-race for these drivers to get tested, tuned up, and ready to go. Right now we're in the middle of qualifying, and Eric Cheney is on the pole with Fast Time. So we're going to sit back and let these guys about qualify, and we'll get back to the starting grid. Alright, qualifying is over, and it looks like Casey Garber got Fast Time in this race. They are starting to grid for the main event. The race is 50 laps. They get one fast repair and no extra set of tires in this race, so you gotta save your tires for the race. Yeah, we're just waiting for two more cars to get on here to start the mains. Looks like it's Casey Garber on inside front row. Eric Cheney's on his outside. Then it is Dylan Huffines. Then Dan Lowther. Troy Day. Josh Washington. Terry Ackerman. Corey Etcheverry. Kyle Matthews. Ron Hunter. Tyler Kim, Chris Kynes, Chris Kamari. That's your starting lineup for tonight. There was no invert tonight, and it looks like they're getting go green right now. Green flag is in the air. It's an even start for the two guys. Garber's still on the inside of Cheney. As they go flying into one. Still coming on the back. Still neck and neck on that back stretch. Garvin finally got clear of Cheney. And Dylan up to the top. Josh Washington is making some moves up to the side. He got a little boost right there. He's screwed. And he's catching it and saves it. Troy Dagg is putting pressure on his back bumper right now. Behind him is Kyle Matthews. Well, Hunter's riding around in the back. Looks like they're all sitting single file. They all got nice spaced out right now. Chris Kynes is got a little squirrely, and Customary is trying to peek underneath him. He's down underneath him. Made a little contact. But the outs. No cards in spinning, so it's okay. The leaders are still 1, 2, 3. It is Casey Garber, Dale Elfine, and Eric Cheney in their top 3. Followed by Dan Lowther and Josh Washington. There's a great single file racing right now for these folks. We're 8 laps in. A 56 lap race, it looks like. Oh, Eric Cheney got a little nose peek underneath that. Dale Elfine, but I mean, single file, that's what we kind of like to see for these drivers. Single file action. Oh, looks like there's a battle in the back there. Just kind of just making some moves now. Let's ride on board with Chris Kynes right now on the gyro cam. Start with that, we're on Chris Camary's. And Chris Camary pulled away from Chris Kynes, so Chris Camary is working on Tyler Kim. Tyler Kim got a little loose. Come back over more with Corey back here in 12th place. Like Chris Kynes got any Tyler Kim. Chris Kynes was trying to fill that hole in, but he got a little loose off that corner. Made a nice time, and nope, he's on the inside now. Like Tyler Kim is starting to fall back a little bit. Nope, now Corey is on the inside of Tyler. And Tyler is just dropping like a rock. Ron Hunter's on the inside now. Tyler Kim fell away to the back now. Let's go up front. Looks like Casey Garber has a nice 2.5 second lead over second place, which is now Eric Cheney. Eric Cheney's got Dylan Huffines all over him. Dylan Huffines is a little sideways right there. Nope, got a side by side battle with Josh Washington and Dan Lowther. Dan Lowther gets into between him, Josh Scott. Oh, Dan Lowther gets a little squirrely again there. Daggett's on the outside of him. They're giving each other plenty of room right there. I think they're finally getting back to signal filed out. Dan Lowther's back on the move again, up to him, try to head back up front to get his positions back that he lost. Nope. Looks like the yellow flag is waving. Let's see what happened, folks. Looks like some a little bit of carnage there, but more happened with Kyle Matthews. Wind it back. Maybe my guy was squirrely, and then Chris Camari comes in there and gets in the back end of him and just keeps sending him around. Looks like it's pretty good damage. Oh, and Ron Hunter gets in the back of Corey there to cause another melee, but they manage to save it and not wreck down the... Alright, so KC Garb's coming in. I think they might have got extra tires in this race because Garber's coming in from the lead with Eric Chaney behind him. Yep, looks like they are taking tires. The top four. Four of them did. Garber, Chaney, Dilly, Evans, Chardaggett. And it's like that one's Aaron Thompson, too. Dylan Huffines and Tornado took right side tires, while Eric Chaney and Casey Garber took four tires. There's also Tyler Kim's rolling in with Kyle Matthews, Ron Hunter, Chris Cummings. They're probably most likely taking faster pairs and using their faster pairs up and getting tires. The thing that's tricky on these cars is this is a small track, and these street stocks take a long time to change tires. A lot of times, if you're not right behind the pace car, we'll go a lap down. You take four tires, but that's why you gotta take two tires, go back out around real quick, and take another two. I know it's a pain, but that's the way to do it. Looks like the pace car ducked on off and green flag up there. Josh Washington is your leader. Dan Larrow's outside. And we go back here with Terry Ackerman's inside of Dan Lather with Dylan Huffines and Chris Camari. Right there. Three cars right there trying to get after that second spot. But right now, Josh Washington is going away. Oh, Dan Lather gave a little bump to Terry Ackerman because he kind of came up in front of him off that corner, so he's just giving him a little displeasure notice. But Dilly got him. Dylan Huffman's got the inside of Terry, and now Chardaggett is. Right behind them is Casey Garber. He is fast. Oop, Dan Lather jumped in front of Eric Chaney. Cut him off. Got pretty hard on the brakes, and he Chris Camara got in the back of him, and Dan Lather again. Casey Garber hit the wall that time. Like everyone's slowing up, there must have been another wreck. Let's go back and see what happened. Oh, looks like Chris Camari went around this time. Let's see what happened. Eric Chaney got in Dan Lather. Dan Lather was sideways. He managed to save it. Chris Camari drove in. Eric Chaney looks like got onto the inside, and Chris Camari pushed up a little bit, got into his left rear, and he just kept on going around. He almost had it saved, and finally ended up looping it, and which brought out the caution, the second caution of the night. Dylan Huffman cycles to the front. I think Josh Washington came in and took some tires. He needs some. He fell to the back down with those fresh tires now. Let's see. He got 22 laps to go. We'll see if he can work his way up front and get this win. this is the rule here. On restarts, the leader would get to choose inside or outside lane on the restart. And he still controls the restart. So he can, when he gets the one to go signal, he'll choose inside or outside, and the rest will line up where they're supposed to be. Only the leader gets choice. And it looks like Dylan have finally choosing the outside on this restart. Let's see if he can get a good jump. Because you got fast Casey Garber starting third. You got Troy Digg on the inside of him. And Terry Aukerman. And Eric Chaney. Looks like the green flag is out. Dylan Hubbine got a great jump. Troy was probably sleeping on that one. There they are going flying down the backstretch, all of them. They're all getting hard on the binders. Starting to single file out. Terry Aukerman is hanging hard on the outside. With Eric Chaney now on the inside. There's Josh Washington behind Eric Chaney. He's trying to go way up there now. We got a hard battle between Chris Kamari and Chris Kynes back here. You got the 73 car blinking a little bit. That makes it a little bit harder for the drivers to see. Dan Lather is trying to get around these drivers. He's fast. Dylan Huffine's got a second and a half lead now, looks like, on everyone. Oh, there is a wreck back there. We caught that one live. Chris Kynes just drove it down in there, got into the back of Chris Kamari, or above his door it says Scary Kamari. They both were working hard to try and save it, and ooh, here comes Aaron Thompson, the 53, just drills Chris Kynes in the door. And the 73 got into it. There comes Tyler Kim trying to avoid all of it, too. Let's see what Tyler has to see about this. He's kind of rolling slow. Oh. I don't know if you saw that until the last second or what. This just comes in. Then he saves it. Doesn't hit anything. Again, we're back up front now with Dylan Huffines, Troy Digg, Casey Garber, Eric Chaney, and Josh Washington in our top five. Now we are with 13 laps to go. Looks like Tyler Kim is the lucky dog. He didn't get his lap back right now. And that will put him back on the lead lap. Chris Kynes was in front of him. But since he was involved in the wreck, he does not get the lucky dog. That gave to Tyler Kim. But he is now should be on the lead lap. Oh, what happened to Dylan Huffines right there? Comes into the corner, just all of a sudden drifts up and hits the wall. So that should give him some damage. Let's go take a look at the right front. Ooh, look at that tire, that's sticking out a little bit. That could affect his aerodynamics. right rear doesn't look so bad. This is Dylan Huffine's right front right here. See how it's kind of the tire sticking out, front is damaged in. You go, this is Troy Day, look out. No damage on the right front, sticking in underneath the fender well. Looks like they got the one to go. Dylan Huffine's chose the outside again. We're gonna restart with, right now it's 10 to go, 9 to go once they get the green. And they're off. Dylan Huffine with another great jump. Casey Garber is on the inside of Eric Cheney. Troy falls in the second place right behind Dylan Huffine. He made a good gain right there. Dylan Huffine is up to holding that bottom line. Eric Cheney and Casey Garber battling hard right now on the for the third spot. Oh, there's a wreck back there. Ooh, with that Corey Utterberger. Dude, that was a nasty wreck right there, it looks like. Let's rewind it back and take a look. Oh, it was like that 53 got into him. There's some Corey into the inside wall, hard hit. And it collects Chris Kynes, Tyler Kim, and Kyle Matthews. They just had nowhere to go. It was just a bang bang play right there. You see that wreck right there in front of him? They're trying to avoid it, but he shot right back to that track so fast that no way to react. This is going to give us another restart with Dylan Huffine in the front. Look at that damage on Tyler Kim's car right there. It was like he just used his fast repair. See how fast that thing healed up? See, he comes in with damage. All crinkled up. Comes in, has fast repair checked. Boop! New car. I think he's smelling that new car smell right now. But it looks like Dylan Huffine is having fun trying to be the pace car. Damage that car is crinkled up all on the right side. Another restart. Dylan Huffine chose the outside lane again. Eric Cheney's to the inside. Casey Garber starting fourth. We're going to be at 3 to go right now. Good restart. Oh, short day, guy, if you reserve inside the other Huffines. He couldn't close the door on this time. They're side by side. Going in at 3. They're beating and banging on the door right there. Casey Garber's trying to get in there next now. White flag's up in the air right now. It's the race will be official no matter what ends it. Dylan Huffines got loose. Garber to the inside of him. Dan Lowther's in the mix now. They're all trying to fight for the wash up. Dylan Huffine in the wall. Trey Kuvair followed by Casey Garber, Dan Lowther, Dylan Huffines, Josh Washington. Top 5, Eric Cheney, Chris Kamari, Terry Ockman, Aaron Thompson, Corey Eckenberger, Tyler Kim, Kyle Matthew, Chris Kynes, Ron Hart. That's your finishing order right now. Looks like Troy Day got spun out after the race. Let's see what happened. Looks like old Chris Kamari was giving saying hi to him, their teammates. Saying congratulations, great win, great job. see if you then go do some donuts. What's going on? Dylan Huffines is trying to do some donuts. This was just a pre-race, folks. I'd like to thank everyone for watching tonight. We'll have more races to follow. Make sure you like the YouTube channel. And we'll have more races to follow.